Since colonial times, Newport has experienced wild swings of fortune. Crippled during the Revolution, it would languish into the 1820s before it was rediscovered as a summer retreat by Southern plantation owners, China trade merchants, artists, and writers. George Noble Jones, a plantation owner from Savannah, commissioned the house we know today as Kingscote in 1839. Enlarged by later owners, the Gothic Revival cottage sat at the head of a dirt road in the southern part of populated Newport. Bellevue Avenue was not even remotely the grand and fashionable avenue it would become 50 years later. But Jones would sell much sooner than that. The Civil War would force him to part with Kingscote. When he did, the little country house began a rebirth that helped it survive to this day. Jones sold the house to China trade merchant William Henry King. In the 1880s, King's nephew David hired the firm of McKim, Mead & White to enlarge and redecorate the house, adding its dining room and upper floors in the center of the house. The architects displayed their talents for the use of color and light in their redecoration, with the first known use of Tiffany glass bricks and a unique cork ceiling in the dining room. Kingscote today is filled with the collections of five generations of the family, reflecting their 18th century Newport heritage, involvement in the China trade, and extensive travels throughout Europe. The house passed from the King family to the Preservation Society of Newport County with the death of Mrs. Anthony Reeves in 1972.